Hello students, now we are going to do some MATLAB experiment on power quality performance analysis for nonlinear loads. So this is the Simulink diagram for the power quality performance analysis for nonlinear loads. So how we can do this experiment in the MATLAB? So I am using 2017p MATLAB. So we can implement the same Simulink model in 2015b and the latest version also. Okay, so first you must create some folder. Okay, go to some documents, and then I'm going to create some folder here, document, that means res, and then I'm going to copy this location. Just I'm going to copy this location, and then I'm going to change the current directory of this MATLAB. So just I'm going to click this one, and then paste that location. And then enter. So you will see that current working directory is changed to res. So now I'm going to click this Simulink. So you will take some time to open that Simulink start page. So here you can just click this blank model, right? So after clicking that one, you will get this model, and then first you save this model, right? Just you go to click this button, save button, and then save the model. So I'm going to save the model as power quality analysis nonlinear loads. Okay, or else you can save with the experiment number. So or else just you go to save the number, save the model, so that the name should be does not have any space, right? And should not have any symbol or a special character. Just you have to use alphabets, okay, continuously. So here I'm used to PQENLL. Okay, just you save this model, and then click this one, right? So this is used for finding the different blocks in order to implement that experiments. So just you have to click this Simulink or library browser, and then comes to Simscape, right? Here Simscape, and then go to Power Systems, and then go to Specialized Technology, and then go to Fundamental Blocks, and then here comes to Electrical Source, right? Click this one. So here you can see that three-phase source, right? So just you have to drag and place here, right? So first you want this three phase source. So this is nothing but the three phase source. So next we need current measurement and voltage measurement, right? So that can be found in the following menu. That means go to measurements, right? Click measurements. And here you can see that, right? Current measurement block and voltage measurement block. Just you have to click and drag, and then click this voltage measurement and drag, right? So next we need this one. This is nothing but universal bridge. Okay, so this can be found in the browser. Go to power electronics, right? Click power electronics, and then come down, right? Here you can see that universal bridge, right? So just you have to drag and then place in the workspace working. So next, so here we need diode, right? Diode rectifier, right? So just you have to click this one. So here you can see that different options. Here we need to use diodes, right? The diode with some load, going back to see a non-linear load, right? That means because of this load, so what happened to the source current, right? Current goes to non-sinusoidal. Okay, so the input quality will be affected because of this non-linear load. So here we need to measure the total harmonic distortion. So when we are going to connect some non-linear load to AC source, okay, just go to click diodes and click okay, and then you have to connect the current source. So just you have to connect this A with this plus point, and then connect this negative to here A, okay, and then connect B to the B, and then C to C, and then we need to connect voltage measurement. So we can connect the voltage measurement in between A and B. Okay, so next we need to connect this one load, right? R load. So here we are going to use series RLC branch. So that can be taken from these elements. So just you to click elements. So here you can see that series RLC branch. Okay, just you have to take this one. So I need to rotate this one, right? So for that, just click this one and then press Ctrl R. So you press Ctrl R, it's going to be rotate. So change the position of this series RLC and then connect the terminals. So now I need to connect only resistor, right? So just you have to click this one. So here you can see that different option is there, right? RLC, RL, RC, LC, open circuit, right? So here we want only R, just go to click R, and then type resistance equal to 1000 ohms. So next we need to connect scope, that means we need to measure the voltage and current of the circuit, source voltage and current. So for that we need to use scope. So scope can be found in the here, right? That means go to sinks. So this is comes under Simulink, right? So go to sinks. So here you can see that scope, right? So just drag here. So here we need to measure two measurements. One is voltage, another one is current, right? So we need to change the parameter here. Just click this one and then go to view under configuration properties. So here we can provide number of input port, right? So here we need to measure two, that means source voltage and current. So I'm going to type two here, and then I'm going to change layout to layout, that means we need to see that the two details, right? Voltage and current. So that's why I'm going to choose vertically to layout and then apply. And also we need to measure the THD. So not to measure the THD, so we need to store the data in the workspace. Okay, so for that go to login, okay, and then click log data to workspace, and then you can change the name or you can leave it the name as it is, no problem. And then you can change the save format structure with time. So just you click structure with time and then apply and then okay. So you will see the two axis here, right? Now to measure voltage and current. So next I'm going to connect the voltage measurement here and then current measurement here. Okay, so next we need to provide input detail, source detail. So just go to click this one, double click this one, and then I'm going to provide the line to line voltage. Here is 400 volt, the frequency is 50 hertz. Okay, and then click untick the internal and then click OK. So the simulation, everything is completed, right? That means Simulink model is created for that power quality analysis of nonlinear load, right? So here you can see that. So this is AC source. So here we are measuring current and voltage. This is going to be act as a nonlinear load. So which rectifier along with the R load. Okay. So next, so if you want to run this model, definitely you will get some error, because we need to simulate this power system block right in the MATLAB. So we need to add another one more block. So that block, just you to click power system and then specialized technology and then fundamental blocks. So click fundamental blocks, right? So after clicking fundamental block, you can see here, right? Power GUI, right? So power GUI is the supporting block in order to execute this power system Simulink block, right? So just you go to track and place here, right? So now model is ready. So I'm going to simulate this model for a 0.4 seconds. So here you can change the time here, right? So I'm going to change 0.4 and then I'm going to simulate the model. Okay. So now we can see the results. Okay. So this is nothing but source voltage. So this is source current, right? So here you can see that the source current is non-sinusoidal. So this is because of this non-linear load, right? So the source is connected, that means load is connected to the source. Because of this load, the input quality, current quality is affected, right? That means it's non-sinusoidal. So definitely the THD, total harmonic distortion of this AC current, source current is increased, right? So next we need to measure the THD of this source current, right? So for that, go to continuous, right? Here, click continuous and then click tools. So here you can see that FFT analysis, right? Click FFT analysis. So after clicking that one, you will see that another window, this window. So in this window, already I told, right, the data is stored in the space, right? Because so see here we are used to, that mean we are log the data into workspace, the name of scope data, right? So you can see here also, here you can see that. So this is the data taken from the scope, right? So we need to see the THD of the source current, right? So first we need to store this data in the workspace, so then only we can see that THD plot for the source current. So here you can, that is scope data. So scope data contain two things. One is voltage, AC voltage and AC current. So this one is nothing but AC voltage. So here the input frequency is 50 hertz. I'm going to change to 50 hertz. And then you can click here, right? So select FFT window and then change 50 hertz and then click display. So now we can see that the THD for a source voltage, okay, the THD is around only 0.15%. okay, that means total harmonic distortion, the harmonic in the AC source is only 0.15%. so normally this percentage should be is less than 5%. As per IEEE standard, this should be less than 5%. So it is less than 5%, no problem. Then AC source voltage is having quality of sinusoidal waveform. So but we need to check the current quality. So for that, I'm going to change the input to, so now we can see that this is the current, source current. So here also I'm going to click FFT window here. So you will see the input, that means single cycle AC current, and then I'm going to click display. So now we can see that the THD value is around 30.28%, right? So the THD of the source current is more than 5%. So the quality of the source current is very high. That means AC current having more harmonics. Okay. So by the way, we can measure the THD. So by the way, we can analyze the power quality of the AC source. Okay. So this is what you are going to do in that experiment. Okay. Thank you.